this is 80s Horror Spotlight, where I shed light on an underrated horror film from each year of the 1980s. The year is 1983. Cabbage Patch Dolls are released, marking the first year of the must-have Christmas craze, which still goes on to this day. The first Costco store is opened, which allows us to buy gluttonous amounts of food, like goldfish boxes the size of shoeboxes. And we have another fantastic year in horror films. However, one movie stands out. Not in quality, oh god no. Not in acting or storytelling, but in its absolutely bewildering nature. Microwave Massacre. I mean, where to even start with this film? I think this was supposed to be like a dark, raunchy comedy with a bit of a horror slant in the over-the-top style of, like, let's say, a Roger Corman film. However, it somewhat fails in this, and at the same time, somewhat completely succeeds in it as well. It's fascinating. Don't get me wrong, it's terrible, but terrible in that 80s horror oddness where you can't take your eyes off it, like a car wreck. The choices and direction of this film are so counterintuitive that you can't ever predict what's going to happen next, even if what happens next is utter nonsense.
I can't understand that, Rosie.
I hate to even try to give you a synopsis of Microwave Massacre because it is so ridiculous that explaining it really can't give you the full picture. But here it goes. Jackie Vernon, in his last feature film, unfortunately, is unhappy in life due to the fact that his bad-tempered and assertive wife has bought a comically large industrial-sized microwave, and he doesn't too much care for the meals she prepares in it. So he kills her. With a pepper grinder. Yeah, it's a bit of an overreaction, but now he has a big, huge problem. What to do with the body? What to do? Easy. Eat it. Which unfortunately becomes a huge obsession, and he begins to pick up prostitutes to feed his cannibalistic appetite.
Now, a special program brought to you by Acme Bail Bonds. Crime Busters!
This movie has that duality nature, where it feels cheap, but it is shot in a way that of a lot of the imagery in the scenes is actually kind of memorable. It's the same feeling you get from movies like Samurai Cop. Most mediocre movies that come out these days, you kind of just digest and immediately forget. But it's this special brand of not good cinema that kind of sticks with you, which in the end, I can appreciate way more. So do I recommend Microwave Massacre? I don't know. I guess I do, but only if you're into a very specific type of cinema. If you need the jump scares of The Conjuring or the complexity and artistry of Silence of the Lambs, then no. But if you are the kind of person who prefers Carnosaur 2 to Jurassic Park 2, then by all means, check it out.